श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। Life with a difference. On this topic, we'll think about what is the meaning of life and what is the difference that we want to see in our life. Normally, life is the quality of our interactions with the world. Suppose we interact with something, like you are all here and you are interacting with the situation that you have come for this workshop for the students, and some of you have come here because you were pushed by your parents and you came somehow. Okay, I'll go. What will be the quality of your life? Disgusting, frustrated, I don't know why. And those of you who have come here of your own choice with a view to learn something so that you grow wise, if you have come with that kind of approach and you are extremely interested in learning something, what will be the quality of your life? You will be enjoying, is it not? So what is a life therefore? Life is the quality of our interactions with the world. Am I clear to everybody? Now, second thing. In our interaction with the world, two components are involved. One is the world, second is ourselves. Can we do anything to the world? Can we do something to us? So there is a possibility that we can work on ourselves in such a manner that the world, whatever it is, you don't have to get disturbed. And therefore, let us understand this principle, how it operates in life. Once I was going by a car somewhere and a friend of mine was driving. So when we were going, suddenly a buffalo came on the road and he asked to stop the car and he became angry. I don't know what is happening to this country. Suddenly one buffalo has come and he has become national. What is happening to the country? Again, after some time, when we were going, there was a big hole, pothole, and he banged in that. Oh God, I don't know where this country is going. Again, he became national. Then we went ahead, and suddenly a scooter took a turn. And he just touched the scooter. The moment his car touched the scooter fellow stopped and started. If you don't know how to drive the car, why do you come? Get out from here. And became angry. And with this kind of thing, we reach our destination. And I was enjoying the whole process. You know, one day, one boy, a Gujarati boy in USA, he asked me this question, Swamiji, don't you like cartoons? I said, I like cartoons. But I have never seen you seeing cartoons. I said, I don't see cartoons in the TV. I see the live cartoons all around me. Now see what happens. Can you do anything about the buffalo? I asked him. I said, who has a driving license? To you or to the buffalo? You have a driving license. So it is your responsibility that when you are driving, you are careful. And second thing, by complaining, problems are not solved. Normally what we do, we complain, 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 and in our complaint there is only one note, that the world should change. World is that which will not change. It is we who have to change. Therefore, when we have to learn about the life with a difference, we have to understand life has these two components. One is ourselves, second is the world. And in these two components, we have to have control on ourselves. We cannot have control on the world. The moment this happens, what will be the next step? You will start correcting, changing, improving yourselves. I will give you one example to make this point. There was one girl from some other country, our Indian girl, and she had some, you know, very fighting kind of life at home, husband and wife, non-stop fighting. So she came and spoke to me. Swamiji, my husband is like that. You tell me, I have done this thing, he has done this thing. Who is right? Who is wrong? So I asked her, who is in front of me? Your husband or you? Of course, I am in front of you. Now for my security, what I will say? You are right. I will not say your husband is right, because then you will bounce on me. But is it going to solve the problem? It is not going to solve the problem. Because suppose I say you are right, you will keep on fighting with your husband and say even Swamiji told that I am right, and you will keep on fighting. Suppose I tell that your husband is right, then you will say Swamiji takes always the side of the boys and never of the girls. So what you are wanting is a sympathy from the world, that the world should change, you are all right. This is a wrong approach in life. So what is the life with a difference? Life with a difference is, instead of discussing, arguing, justifying and reasoning, find out how we can dissolve the problem. See, please take this very clearly in your mind. Your life will be totally different. You must be having this thing at home. Some of your elders must be having their own way of living. And it doesn't suit you, it doesn't fit in your frame of understanding. And then what do you do? That you either react, you become frustrated. You always remember that you have a limitation of your own existence. Don't cross your limits. Many times what we do, we cross our limits. Never get involved into the arguments and logic of your parents. Let them work it out. You relax. Otherwise, you will make your life miserable. Therefore, life with a difference is, we have to be very careful and clear that in our interaction with the world, we interact in such a manner that we remain undisturbed and untouched. That is the life with a difference. Otherwise, like everybody, you know, Swami, you tell me under this condition anybody will become miserable, and that anybody I am miserable. Don't justify you are miserable. Don't. Otherwise, you will never come out of your wrong habits. So life with a difference means we have to take a bold step that in this world, to improve the quality of our life, we are 100% responsible. Now take for example, miseries come in our life because of something or somebody, agreed. But we all become miserable by our own choice. make it clear. Nobody is miserable because of anybody unless you cooperate with the misery. See, for example, suppose I go to her house. And after I go, I get lot of respect, love, affection. What I will do? I will go again. Again I will go. Why? Because I am received with honor and respect. In the same manner, when the miseries come to me and I become miserable, what Miss Misery will think? Here is a place where I am honored and respected. So all the miseries will start coming to you. So they will talk among themselves. You want to go to Ahmedabad? Go to her house. You get a lot of comfort. No. Let the miseries come, but you refuse to be miserable. This is life with a difference. Don't justify. Under this condition, anybody will be miserable. No. Refuse means refuse. Now, the next step. In this interaction with the world, which gives us the quality of life, what are the factors that we have to remember? Now, factor number one. It is we who have to change and grow, not the world. Now, like you are all sitting over here, and I am teaching you something. Now, where is your attention? Your attention is whether you are understanding or not, is it not? Will this boy get up and say, Swamiji, that corner girl is not understanding properly. Will you please explain again? No. In the class, we are here to learn ourselves, is it not? Our life is a university. In this world, we are here to learn and grow wise. Let us not bother about the world. You grow wise. And when you grow wise, you will see wise people are never miserable. You know, Bhagavad Gita says, Gatasuna Gatasuncha Nanu Shochanti Pandita. Wise people are never miserable. So what is a life with a difference? A person who is able to be cheerful and happy in spite of all the problems in life, that is a life with a difference. And for that, our attention is on ourselves. It is we who have to decide. Now the next step, life with a difference. See what happens. We in the modern days always talk about our rights. And as a result, we are only fighting for getting our rights. Now take this example. We are all here. I am your teacher and you are the students. So you have a right on me that I should teach you properly so that you understand. Is it not? Now if you keep on shouting that Swamiji should do his duty, I may not. Because I am not under your control. Contrary to that, if I am responsible myself and I do my duty sincerely of teaching you properly, is it not in the fulfillment of my duty towards you, your rights are taken care of? Think. Now the other way around. I, as a teacher, will have right on you as a students. All the students should now attend properly, should not sleep in the class, should not eat the nails. They should keep the nail eating program after going home. Okay? Now can I do anything about it? I cannot do anything. So what will happen? I will become frustrated, I will become angry with you. On the contrary, if you yourself are responsible and you fulfill your duty of attending the class sincerely, what will happen? My right on you will be already taken care of. So what is the conclusion? Conclusion is, when we fulfill our duties, in the fulfillment of our duties, the rights of others on us are taken care of. See? It's a very basic principle, friends. And you know the beauty of it? To fulfill my duties is in my hands. I don't have to depend on others. Therefore, life with a difference is, do your job cheerfully and happily and relax. That is the life with a difference. Don't bother, they should have done this way, that should have done. No, you do your job and enjoy your life. About this, I'll give one example. There was one girl and a boy, brothers and sisters. When I went to their house in the afternoon for a cup of tea at about 4:30, 5 o'clock, it so happened that the boy and the girl together came. The moment they entered, the boy threw his shoes and the book bags and rushed to the sofa and sat with the remote control and started seeing the cartoon, and from there shouted, "Mom, give me something to eat," watching the cartoon. And the girl, she went to her room and she did not come. So I asked the mother, I said, "Mama, this fellow is enjoying and asking and demanding. What about your daughter? She doesn't come." "No, Swamiji, she is very peculiar." "What is that?" "After she comes from the school, without changing her uniform, she will complete her whole homework. After that, she will change and come." I said, "Very peculiar. Why?" "You ask her, we don't know." So after she came out, I asked her. I said, "Hey, you don't enjoy cartoons and all that?" "Of course I enjoy." "Then why didn't you come right in the beginning like your brother?" "Swamiji, I have to complete my homework." "He also has the homework." "Swamiji, his homework is completed by mom and dad. I had to complete my own homework." Then I said, "Why, your dad doesn't do your homework?" "No, he does. But it is all wrong and I get the punishment. And therefore, I had to do my job." Now see the beauty. She said, "When I know that I have to do my homework, why not I finish once for all and then enjoy?" This is life with a difference. Don't keep anything pending for tomorrow. Whatever you have to do, you finish it today itself and go to sleep or enjoyment with full heart. Normally what we do, that aaj kare so kal kar, kal kare so parso, parso bhi kya karna, are baba jeena hai ab barso. No, finish your job there and then. You know, the other day, here itself or somewhere, one elderly person came and he asked me one question. He said, "Swamiji, you have written so many books, more than 50, 60 books, fat. You have written so many books." I said, "Yes." "You keep on moving around the world?" "Yes." "You have given so many talks?" "Yes." "You have got so many CDs, video, DVDs." "Yes." "Where do you get the time from?" "We don't get time. How can you do that?" I said, "Look here. The principle that I follow in life, every day is a working day in my life. There is no holiday. So what happens? You get 365 days a year. Second thing, I don't do the same job twice. Normally what happens, suppose you have to write an article or essay. What we do, we start, I don't think it is going to it. And again we start writing. I am not getting any mood, you know, I live with you, see, after some time. So to write an ordinary letter or an article, we put 100 efforts and yet it doesn't come out. Now what is the reason? Be very attentive. If you develop a faculty by which you are able to do the job only once and finally perfect, you will never be short of time in your life. All those who say that there is less of time in life, they do not know how to utilize the time. So what is the problem? The problem is when we are working, our mind is somewhere, our hands are somewhere, and our job is somewhere. Like, you know, ek dil ke tukde hajar hoy. See? And as a result, we are never integrated personality. So when we are studying, that time we remember, I don't know what is the score going on. So our mind is in the cricket. And when we are watching the cricket, then we are worried, I hope the, you know, dad doesn't come and scold me. And in this manner, we are never available for any job fully. Now watch your own mind's friends. Here I am talking to you for 60 minutes. I talk to you 60 minutes since. Tell me sincerely, do you hear me all the 60 minutes? Because even this is not heard. Because the mind has already taken a detour. The mind goes here and there. It is not anybody's fault. It is only our not becoming aware that this is how the mind is playing fool with us. You know, one day what happened? One lady came to meet me in Bombay, like a devi. There was some kind of bandage tied down to her hand, and she came, Swamiji, I want to talk to you. Now imagine when somebody comes to you in this posture, what it is. So I did namaskar to her. I said, Mahadevi, Mahakali, Namaste. He said, Swamiji, you are making fun of me. I said, no, Amma, you are coming in that, you know, Abhaya Mudra. So I said, all right. She said, you know what happened? I said, I don't know what happened. You are giving me Ashirvad, so I am receiving. He said, no. Actually, you know, when I was cooking, I had a very heated argument with my husband. And in that, talking to him, and he was angry, and I was angry, and I was that time preparing chapati and all that, and I totally forgot everything, and I thought there is a chapati on the tawa, and the tawa was red hot, and I put my hand to take out the non-existing chapati, and tawa came to my hand, and it got burnt. And afterwards, no, I'm so sorry. Then the husband came running. Oh, your one hand only got burnt. Why don't you put another one? Now, why this happens is only because our mind is somewhere else. Our hands are somewhere else. Our job is somewhere else. Imagine a car. You are driving the car and there is a need that you have to apply a brake here immediately, otherwise you will commit an accident. But you have a car which is unique. When you apply brake in Ahmedabad, the car stops in Baroda. What will be the condition? In the same manner, our mind is running with such a tremendous speed, and we are unable to have any control on that. This is how all the abnormalities develop in children. Have very clear understanding. Instead of struggling to control the mind, start taking interest in whatever you do. Everything that you do, do with great joy. Take interest. Don't do anything, I'm camera going on. You must have seen those people who eat chewing gums. They are the most disgusted people on the whole universe. You know. They must have been buffaloes in the last life, you know. He must have seen, at least buffaloes are eating comfortably. They will sit in the middle of the road and take out whatever they have eaten hurriedly and slowly. You go on honking, nothing happens. Meditation. See? You know, when we are not able to take interest in anything in life, be very attentive. It is first sign of depression. Do you know the word ras? Rasik bhai. There are people who cannot enjoy anything. They have no ras in their life. When you don't have ras, you are lazy. No. Learn to take interest in every small little thing that you do. Your mind will be always under your control. It's a very simple technique. If you have to write, write beautifully. Enjoy. If you have to talk, talk every word distinctly, clearly. If you have to walk, walk in such a manner that every step you take is a determined step, not like a bhajak bhat bhat bhajak are gir gaya are ram ram. See, then it is a life with a difference. If you don't take care of your mind with this technique, take interest in whatever you do, you know what will happen. I'll give one example. There was one Bengali boy in Delhi. He completed his second year of BSc. And third year he failed 3 times. So at home, father and the son, always on war. So the mother of that boy, she was known to me, she one day came. Swamiji, this is the problem, I don't know what to do and all that. I said, if he's free, let him come and talk to me. I'll spend some time with him. He came. I said, you stay with me, I got a big house, so you stay for 3-4 days, I am free, you also can enjoy. And then we used to watch TV and movie and cricket, nothing other than his interest. After 2 days, he got confidence in me. Then he himself opened up. He said, Swamiji, I got a problem. I said, what is the problem? See, 3 years I failed. And the reason is, I am unable to control myself. I said, what happened? Now see his problem. He said, my problem is, when I am going anywhere, suddenly I look at a girl, and then I get lost. And then I follow that girl, wherever she is going, and it becomes not say 2 hours, 3 hours, but up to 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. And I keep on waiting outside her house, just thinking about her. And I just can't do anything. I know it is wrong. In examination, suppose I am writing in my paper, and after writing something, then I look this side, I look at another girl, and gone. I don't know what I should do. Now he was seen, that is his problem. Now what can he do? So I helped him, I told him what is to be done. He came out of that problem. He came out with very good marks. He got his first international job. He gave his fat salary first check to me. Amadi, because of you, I am what I am. I had destroyed 3 years of my life. I said, all right now, go and enjoy. What was his problem? His problem was, he was unable to know that he is being carried away by the whim and fancy of the mind. Is it not? Now, such people, they are normally taken to the doctors, and the doctors will start giving them sedatives, and then they become hanging. What happened to you? Nothing happened. Doctor, give me. Such people only carry the load of death on their head. Friends, today in the whole world, be very attentive. Highest serious disease is not AIDS of virus. It is the disease of depression. And this disease is not among the poor people. It is among the middle class and the rich people. Because they are not employing their mind in a creative manner. Only getting indulgent in the world. Therefore, life with a difference is, keep some goal to be achieved in life. Be inspired and work hard to get the goal done. Don't just live through life because you are not able to die and therefore you are living. No. Have some purpose fitted. Have some goals fixed. Then you will be able to bring out the best out of you. Otherwise, life will become only a burden. See, I was staying with them in Australia, my host. The father is 80, mother is 75, the son is 55. At this age of 55, that fellow is good for nothing. He is under depression, drugs, medicines, and an old mother. He goes on demanding, prepare this thing, prepare that thing, I want this, I want that, I will not do this thing, get me from there. And the old mother is running day and night. And this fellow is so dull, so stupid. Do you think it is life worth living? What is the reason? Reason is, he is not leading a responsible life. So you have to account for every moment of your life. Now I am taking you one step further. Life with a difference means you account for every moment of your life. Don't give freedom for so-called relaxation. You know the best way of relaxation is what? I'll tell you my example. You can visit my website. My website is www.BeHappyInc. One word, all small cases. BeHappyInc.org, org, organization. You visit. Now, there you will see my itinerary for 2006. From 1st of January 2006 to 31st of December 2006, what I have to do is already fixed. There is no time to loiter. There is no time to say, I am getting bored. Who cares? You have a job. Do that. If you keep yourself 24 multiplied by 7, busy, you will be the happiest person in the world. So what is the meaning of a life with a difference? You give zero holidays to yourself. No holiday. Every day is a working day. Your life will be totally different. Now tomorrow is Saturday, Sunday. So how we celebrate Saturday, Sunday? Get up late, up to 10 o'clock, keep in the bed, and that is a celebration. Dumb. You know, those who sleep very long in the bed, in their next life, they become bed bugs. So when you are sleeping, if you see a bed bug, you say, "Acha, agle janam mein apne ko yehi banna hai." Don't continue to be lazy on the bed. So when you thus keep yourself busy, then when will you relax and all that? I'll tell you a technique of relaxation. Life with a difference. What is the technique? Change your job. Suppose you are studying and you are tired, then don't throw it and sleep. No. Then you leave that study or reading and do some physical work. Take out the walls, clean them, and fix them. Take all your books out, clean them, again rearrange them. Or go and wash your clothes, or go and help your mom. Changing the job is a best way of relaxation. Only lazying is not the way of relaxation. When you are completely tired and exhausted, go to sleep. And if you are not able to go to sleep instantaneously on your bed, get out and do some physical job. You will develop a life with a difference. And such people are really, really a creative genius in this world. Therefore, don't yield to laziness. To get out of it, you have to plan something to be achieved in life. Thereafter, work for that achievement. And in this manner, when you plan your life, that every moment is a moment of celebration. No more depression and dejection. I don't feel like doing anything today. You say this thing every day, not today. Such people who don't have interest in life, they become a boredom for others. You all must be having this experience. In the company of some people, you just don't want to be, isn't it? Oh, that bore has come. Now, what is the bore anyway? I don't know, but whenever that fellow comes, you know, it is so boring, you know. And we do the same thing. I was feeling so bored, I thought, let me go to my friend. Why you are feeling bored? I was all alone. You are feeling bored of whom? Of myself. Okay. That means you are such a solid bore that you are bored of yourself. Then I thought, why not do some social service? So I took my boredom with a social justice to distribute it freely. And then we have a complaint. The other day, one girl came to me. She said, "Swamiji, please help me." I said, "I don't help anybody monetarily. What is next? No money I don't want. Then what is that? I don't know. But I don't have a single friend. Nobody wants me. I tried to go and mix with somebody, they don't want me. I go to somebody's house, they find out some excuse and go away. If there are people sitting together, if I happen to go there, like after Odomos is applied, all the mosquitoes go away. Wherever I go, people disappear. Why? I said, Amma, I also want to go. Now tell me, why people don't like us? Become very aware of this phenomena. About this, I'll tell you, one elderly lady, wife of a politician, central minister, from south. She had about 8 or 9 sons. Old lady, very educated, did a lot of studies, doctorate and various things. And all her sons very well placed, all married, all have got children. And on one Diwali, I was with them. A huge hall and a nice swing. So I was sitting on the swing and one grandchild here, one grandchild here. And all of us sitting, giggling, laughing, music and everything was, Diwali celebrations were going on. And this old lady, she was busy in the kitchen scolding the servant, do this, do that and all that, doing some puja and all that. And after all that was over, when she came in our gathering, one by one, everybody started remembering something or the other. Somebody wanted to phone, somebody wanted to study, somebody wanted to fold the clothes, somebody wanted to go to bathroom, somebody wanted to read. And in this manner, in no time, everybody dispersed. And I was left alone as a victim. Jaun to jaun kahan? So she came and sat next to me. I said, hey Krishna. And then she said, Swamiji, have you seen? I said, what, Amma? This is what happens. I have done everything for them. I don't know. Nobody wants me. My husband doesn't talk to me. My children don't talk to me. My daughter-in-laws don't talk to me. My grandchildren don't talk to me. Swamiji, why? I said, Amma, I also don't want to talk. Run. Why this happens? Be very attentive. Now this is the last principle I am telling you, life with a difference. Wherever you go, give respect to the person who is in front of you. Talk his subject. Talk his topic.
Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate.
First. Second thing, do not bring the topic of a third person singular. He is like that, she is like that. Don't get lost in a gossip column. Third, don't go on blowing your own trumpet. In some place I saw a very beautiful sticker. If you have to blow, blow your nose. Not trumpet. Normally what we do as youngsters, either we go on talking about us or we go on talking about somebody who is not present. The best way is, suppose I am in front of you, I should talk what interests you. About your welfare, about your studies, about your mother, about your father. This is the way. You will never, never be disliked by anybody in the world. It's very important. Otherwise, what happens? We have all good intentions. And then we get totally lost in this world. Although we want to be good, but we cannot be good. Now, one caution. When we go and talk to people, never get involved in their personal life. Talk general things. How is your health? How is your work? Like that. You know, one of my friend, he came with me. We went to somebody's house. And I told him, I said, hey, don't go and ask all unwanted things. But you know, some elderly people have got this habit. They want to take your kundali out. And that house which we visited, they were Germans. This happened in outside India. So I told him, I said, look here, when we are going, don't go on asking unwanted question. I said, no. He said, all right. Now, you know, in the Western world, it is considered as a bad manner when you ask somebody about their personal life. But he being a typical Hindustani Gujarati, beta, kaise ho? Theek hai. Shadi ho gayi? Nahin. Kyun nahin? Abhi toh tum badi ho gayi ho na, shadi kar lo. Why worry about somebody else? If you want, you get 3 times married. Don't bother about others. See? Another place I went, very nice family, and we were sitting, everything was going, and one person asked a question. There was no need. Hey, you don't have children? Now, if the children were, they will come in front. What is the need? You don't have children. Why? Did you show to the doctor? Let us go to the doctor. So when we don't understand when to talk what, we become most unwanted people in the world. You must have that common sense. Don't get involved into people's life unnecessarily. No blowing your own trumpet. No talking about the third person, a gossip column. Then talk in general. Give importance to the value, the problems of the person in front of you, and live happily. Now, when you are busy with this, what will happen? You will have no time to bother about your problems to others. This is the habit only which makes us like that. About this, I'll give one example. This happened in Delhi. There used to be one Punjabi family, and an old grandmother. Whenever I'll go to her. Amma, how are you? Fine, everything nice. So Amidi, come, please come, I'd like to tell you something. And then she will start about the pains in her body. Swamiji, when I sit like this now, see, pain comes here, you know. And she is so painful, so pain comes here. And then, you know, it goes like that, you know. And then it doesn't stop here, it spreads from here to here. And when you listen, you start getting pain. And she starts telling it again and again. So she being old has to listen. Now her grandson, one day when she started telling, he called me, Swamiji, please come quickly for a short time. I said, Amma, wait a minute, I am going to him and come back. I went to him. He said, how can you tolerate grandma telling you the same thing so many times? I said, now what can I do? Do the same thing what we do. What do you do? When she repeats the same story 3-4 times, we show her fingers. Nadima. That means you have already told 3 times, now don't tell. I said, hey, this is a good technique. So I went back and she said, Swamiji, what I was telling you, I have forgotten. Never mind, I start again. I said, my God. And when she again started, then I said, Mama, you have told me 25 times. Oh, those people told you, I know. Say, don't spread your miseries among people. Keep your pains to yourself. If you have to tell, tell the doctor. Don't tell everybody, you know. I got pain here, pain there, pain everywhere. No need. There's no need. And in this manner, start living cheerfully and happily to spread joy around you. Now, when you thus have decided to live with a difference, now this is the general disposition of life I told you. Now, the second thing, you have to discover what is the area which interests you And what is the area in which you can really do good? There are two things. One is what you like. Second is for what you are fit. About this, I'll tell you one example. One girl from South Africa, Gujarati girl, she had a notion, she wants to become a film actress. And all the time in that mood, I want to become a film actress, only daughter of the parents. So when I visited their house, both the parents were telling Swamiji, our Toral, she wants to become a film actress, and she's all the time only about that only and all that. So I don't know what to do and all that. And for that she wants to go to Bombay and go to Bollywood and join film actress course and all. I said, okay, I'll talk to her. One day I asked her, when she was in college, first year or so, I asked her, what is your age? Swamiji, I am 20 plus. That's very good. How many times you have acted in drama? Never. How many times you have come in the advertisement serials? Never. How many times you have acted on the TV serials? Never. On what ground do you say you want to become an actress? Tell me. You may like it, but if you have that faculty, you would have started doing it right from childhood. And nobody has asked you to do, even in your school or college. In your school, college dramas, did you act on the stage? No. Then why do you think that you are fit for that? So, Amini, am I not fit for that? I said, if you want to hear from my mouth, no. Then she started crying. I said, crying is not going to solve the problem. Be realistic in life. No, Swamiji, but I want to be. I said, you want to be means what? Are you going to tell the whole lot of the people, hey people, I want to be an actress? I said, chehra dekho. Look your face into the mirror. You want to become an actress. But then what I should do? That was the dream of my whole life. I said, dreams are wonderful, but dreams are never lived. Therefore, two things. First, you must know your capacity, your abilities. And then among them you select. You neither have a good figure, nor you have a good beauty, nor you are having any talent, nor you have got a very deep voice, nor you can speak properly. And I want to become an actress, Swamiji. No. Therefore, be realistic in life. And with that realistic approach, fix the goal, work for it, and slowly, slowly come out. Now, when you are thus wanting to achieve some goal in your life, what is required in today's world is, only your academic qualifications are not enough. That time has gone. In addition to your academic qualifications, you are required to be smart in today's world. Now, what is the smartness in today's world? One of the most important area is the art of communication. And in that art of communication, you must have one command over language. Proper pronunciation. Ability to read and express yourself clearly what you want to say. And this will not happen by accident. So what is to be done for this area? How many of you do this exercise? Take a newspaper or something and read loudly without making mistakes. you must not be doing it. If you are not doing it, start doing it. Spend at least 15 minutes, half an hour for this exercise. Take newspaper, Times of India, Indian Express, whichever, and read the editorial or good articles, the speaking tree and all those things, and read loudly. When you start reading loudly, your speed of speech and thinking, it starts getting properly synchronized. Many people who are not able to talk properly, what is the reason? The reason is their thinking speed is faster than their talking speed. You must have seen sometime, you know, on TV, these various programs come. That fellow has said like them, no sound. Afterwards the sound comes. In the same manner, it happens with us. We say something mentally, but nothing comes out from the mouth. Therefore, to improve the skills of communication, this is one technique, try. Read loudly, slowly. By this, you will improve your vocabulary, your expressions, your art of talking, your art of communication, usage of the words, punctuation, syntax, all these things are essential if you really want to communicate with a difference. One. Now, the second thing. Your speech can really improve if you chant anything in Sanskrit. Sanskrit is the most scientific language in the whole world. So you just start that, you will see the difference. You take us, let us say, Bhagavad Gita and read or chant slowly. Urdvamulamadashakam ashvattham prahuravyayam. Slowly, slowly, when you keep on chanting Sanskrit shlokas, your all the organs of speech, they get proper articulation and proper exercise. By that, not only you are able to read or chant or pronounce properly, but you get a lot of knowledge and wisdom. And thus, improve your communication skills by reading and talking in a proper manner. Don't consider this as an unwanted thing. I'll tell you one thing. When I was maybe his age, very small, 5-6 years or so, those days, this typhoid was a very killing disease. And my elder brother suffered from typhoid. So when he suffered from typhoid, in the, you know, want of proper medication, he was down twice, thrice, relapse, and as a result, he was not able to talk. So when he was not able to talk, I, as his younger brother, used to imitate him, do mimicry. Pani chahiye. Mummy, like that. And I started doing this mimicry so much, he grew all right, but I developed this defect. And I was never able to talk one single sentence in my life up to the class 10th. Never able to talk. Everybody is to make fun of me. Because I have developed that technique. Suppose the teacher asks some question. And he asks the question and I am fixed. Nothing comes out. So I said, hey, this is not going to help me. And then I started these two techniques. So I had to take Gita and sit in a corner and start reading loudly. And then I started taking the newspaper and start reading loudly. Slowly, slowly, in a period of a year or two, all the defects which were developed in the mouth, they were sorted out. Therefore, what I am telling you is out of experience, not imagination. Develop your communication skills perfectly well. Then alone it will help you to lead a life with a difference. And such a person who has this is going to win the game of life and never be defeated. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.